Good morning. My topic is reasons for slowing down of Indian economy. First of all, cause of economic slowdown. Cause of this slowdown include COVID-19, lockdown, demonetization, stress banking sector, GST implementation, and problem in agriculture sector. Demand for labor exists only when there is demand for goods. So growth is necessary if employment is to be assured. Number one is COVID-19. India is under constant lockdown since March 2020 on account of coronavirus pandemic. All the economic activities has come to stand still. Industries are shut. Second one is tight monetary and fiscal policy. If there is inverse relation in interest rates and economic growth rate. If interest rates are high, then economy will not able to grow. Third one is GDP and demonetization. The GDP growth rate of India declined to 3 year by 5.7% in March. By 5.7% in March-June 2017 quarter, it was 6.7% in the last quarter, January to March 2017. This is the slowest growth rate recorded in 2 years and has led India's loses status as the world's fastest growing major economy to China. Fourth one is demonetization. Demonetization was a negative shock to the economy and wiped out 84% of the cash in circulation overnight. Uncertainty caused due to GST led to the shocking of goods ahead of its implementation of 1st July 2017. Fifth one is farmers' empty pockets. Farmers are the major source of our country economic growth. If farmers are not in good situation, then our country will not grow. Sixth one is rising pool of unemployment. There is only a pool of unemployed person in India to absorb, but the country also need to provide unemployment to youth continuously entering the labor force. The slowing of the economy is a source of concern as an economy that has led been slowing for 5 quarters and unlikely to turn around quickly. No demand, no investment. Since it is capital formation or investment that drives growth in the economy, investment is an immediate source of demand as firms that invest buy goods and services to do so. It also expands the economic capacity to produce. Eighth one is reforms. Structural reforms are being taken by almost all of the government, or they have been claiming to doing for more or less quarter of century now since 2014. In particular, the ease of doing business has received great attention from this government, but the economy today is still less regulated than it was in 1991. Labor market reforms has not been taken up yet in parliament. Share of manufacturing may rise if the labor market is liberalized. Ninth one is corporate sector and industry. Although a concrete plan to address the problem is being developed in consultation with Prime Minister Narendra Modi, however, a section of the industry may economist has criticized the government for the not being prudent enough to read the distress sign for treating the slowdown as temporary and transient. 10th one is too much debt. Added to this is the fact that most public sector banks are saddled with high NPA that have resulted in them tightening lending and instead seeking deposit of otherwise repairing their balance sheet by making provision for bad loans. 11th is right out of the storm. Lastly, the slowdown is also part of the longer term structural shift wherein the economy shifting gears from high investment era to low investment era as well, as transition from being cash-driven economy to a digital-enabled economy. Indeed, there can be seen most of the real estate sector that has come to a green in recent months and hence has also contributed to the slowdown. All in all the factors have caused a perfect storm for all Indian economy. There has to be a time lag before one can reasonably and realistically expect a turnaround. Now, slowdown in sectors. Consumption sector. Consumption is the main driver of Indian economy. The growth rate in consumption declined to 6.6% in April to June quarter 2017 from 8.6% in April to June quarter 2016. Part of the reason is that consumer demand was hit as demonetization caused this cash crunch in the economy. Second, investment sector. Private investment is measured by the variable gross fixed capital formation. If GFCF as a percentage of GDP has declining for 5 years now, it grew at a rate of 29.8% in quartile one as compared to 31% last year. The credit flow to industries also slowed down due to the twin balance sheet problem. Third one is government sector. The government expenditure is also slowed down. There is a little scope to increase it without breaching the fiscal deficit target. Net export sector. There has been export stagnation and export grew at 1.2% last quarter. Export is essential to GDP growth. Structural reform will have to be undertaken to enable a robust growth in export by improving productivity. In this regard, the RBI can also intervene to keep the appreciating exchange rate of the rupee in check, which has made import cheaper and export more expensive in relative terms. Fifth one is interest rate sector. Interest rates are high in India. A rate cut is necessary to make borrowing easier. If there is negative relationship between interest rates and GDP, therefore the RBI has to cut interest rate to increase the GDP in the economy. Manufacturing sector. The output of the Indian manufacturing sector shrank to the lowest in 8 years. In August 2019, the index of industrial production fell by 1.4% in September. The IIP declined to 4.3%. In September, consumer durable fell by 9.9%. Capital good output declined by 20.7%, and infrastructure and construction good fell by 6.4%. The only division that tested success was the intermediate goods sector, which grew by 7% in same month. Now, how can India come out of the slowdown? First measure is more government expenditure. Government needs to spend more now to overcome the situation. Although the government has already spent much out of its budgeted expenditure, it needs to spend more to spur investment and demand in the economy. If there is investment in economy, there is a demand in economy, and this will lead to growth in economy. Let Indian rupee be weaker. Even a weaker Indian rupee should not be a problem. Stronger rupee is hurting both the export and the business. Imports are surging and they are eating into a domestic market share. India needs growth now, so there is no need for rating as of now. Third measure is low lending rates. The recently announced monetary policy of RBI has not given any relief to boost Indian economy. The economists now advocate a steep rate cut in the benchmark lending rates to allow more monetary policy expansion. The Reserve Bank need to cut interest rate for bank, thereby making borrowing cheaper for the industry and spurring investment. Certainty in business required. More certainty in the business environment is required. Businesses should be without shock, like demonetization. In fact, after demonetization shock, there is an environment of uncertainty in the economy. This stops the private sector short of announcing the new project. There should be an environment of uncertainty that no such distributive moves would rock the economy in the near term. Fifth one is no need for excuses for spending rural areas. The government need to spend more in rural areas. Increasing rural people income can drive up the consumption demand, which in turn will boost the industry. To create more demand, the government need to spend more in rural areas, construction sector and unorganized sector. Sixth one is World Bank is hopeful for us. The recent slowdown in India, economic growth is temporary in an appreciation, mainly due to temporary disruption in preparation for GST. It will get corrected in the coming month. The World Bank President Jim Yong Kim said that the GST is going to be a hugely positive impact on Indian economy. According to him, we think that the recent slowdown is an aberration which will correct in the coming month, and the GDP growth will stabilizing during the year. Seventh, Vocal for Local. Vocal for Local is a government initiative. It is also termed as Atmanirbhar Bharat. In time of distress, it is important to step up and do everything we can to help reviving the Indian economy and work toward equipping our business with the tools to tide through such circumstances. The best way to do so, this is by being completely self-reliant and calling for a new form of globalization. Eighth one is China's loss can be India's gain. In such COVID scenario, economic and financial distancing from China may be a policy prescription not only for the US and its Western allies, but also for other countries, including India. India can be the next destination, provided we ready ourselves to leverage the opportunity. This requires government incentives, center-state coordination, and joint venture offer from Indian corporate. Conclusion. The aspiring and pervasive COVID-19 pandemic has distorted the world's thriving economy in unpredictable and ambiguous terms, but it signifies indicated that the current downturn seems primarily different from recession of the past, which has jolted the country economic order, whereas the nation conglomerates, corporation and multinational continue to understand the magnitude of the pandemic. It is undoubtedly the need of the hour to prepare for the future. This is sustainable, structural, and more viable for living and working. Thank you.